Okay, now let us start the class today. Today we will have book work of chapter 2, the two sculptors of your English course book. And this is the fourth class or the fourth session, or you can say this is the part 4 of chapter 2, the two sculptors. And we will have some of the exercises. Let me revise what we did in the previous part. In the previous part, we did learn interesting things. That was A4 exercise, and we have done the exercise B synonyms. That was on page number 17. Okay, and some of the words we have written as synonyms, and those were stingy or miserly. Okay, that day I have not told you the meanings, I think. As I am reminding, so stingy or miserly means not generous. Okay, being generous means like it is the quality of a person. Like I have told you that some people are there who want to give more, who want to give anything that they have. ठीक है, अपने पास अगर कोई चीज है, किसी को जरूरत है तो उसे दे देना, इट इज कॉल्ड जेनरसिटी. ओके, और अगर आप कोई हेल्प कर सकते हो और आप हेल्प कर दो, दैट मींस यू आर जेनरस. बट इफ यू आर नॉट डूइंग इट, दैट मींस यू आर मिजर, दैट मींस यू आर स्टिंगी. सो वी कैन से दैट लक्ष्मण वॉज जेनरस, बट चंद्रा वॉज stingy. He was not generous. Okay, treasure, I have told you the meaning. Treasure means khazana, and the synonym is wealth. Groan means to moan. Moan means to show sadness. Okay, when you are happy, you show happiness, but if you are not happy, you show sadness. Hai na, aap jab jo दुखी होने को बोलते हैं टू ग्रोन एंड टू मोन. हेराल्ड, दैट मीन्स अ मैसेंजर. बर्स्ट, वी हैव लर्न्ड इन द स्टोरी दैट बर्स्ट मीन्स अ स्टैच्यू. और ब्लंट, ब्लंट मीन्स दैट इज नॉट शार्प, इट इज डल. ओके, नाउ यस्टरडे एज यू वर हैविंग अ लॉट, you were having some written work, so I did not give you homework. Now today's homework I am giving you now itself. After that I will take the class, and later on I will repeat the same orally. So your homework of the day is you have to write the synonyms of, although I know that you have written it in your classwork in the previous part, but today also you have to write it in your homework copy. Okay, your homework is write the synonyms of, WRITE, write the synonyms of. Write the synonyms of, and this is the B question in your book on page number 17. On page number 17. On page number 17. So have you got the answer? Have you got the homework? That what is your homework? Your homework is write the synonyms of from page number 17 from your book. And in your book there were only 3 to 4. I have given you 2 more. So you have to write all 6 words and their synonyms that I gave you in the previous part. Now this is your homework of the day. You have to learn and write. Learning and writing means you have to learn it orally, and you have to learn the spellings as well as the meanings. coming forward to the next exercise. Now we are here in page in chapter 2, the two sculptors, part 4. The students who have just now joined, please write up your names. Write your names. Yes, Mushika, have you joined the class? Now, I want to tell you something new today. Okay? I will write some of the naming words. Basically, we have to count the things today. Okay? I will draw some pictures and you have to count them. Now, how many are there? If I am drawing flowers, can you count them? If I am drawing flowers, can you count them? Agar main flowers yahan draw karu, to kya aap ise count kar sakte hain? Yes.
A L
Let me give you some of the examples that we can count the number of boys. We can count the number of boys. So boy is a countable noun. We can count the number of girls. So girl is a countable noun. We can count number of schools. School is a countable noun. We can count number of fans. So fan is a countable noun. Okay, and don't get confused for noun. Noun means naming words that you learnt in class 1. Okay, the same thing is called noun here. So the things that can be counted are called countable nouns. The things that can be counted are called countable nouns. Ab mera ek question hai ki humne ye jana that we can count flowers. We can count flowers. But agar bahut sare flowers ho, okay, if there are n number of flowers, theek hai ma'am, ne abhi use kiya n number of flowers. N number of flowers matlab count to kar sakte hain, but we are unable to count at an instance. Usi waqt turant hum use count nahi kar sakte. Okay, suppose if you have gone to a garden. अगर आप एक गार्डन गए हैं और आपने देखा कि वहां फूल ही फूल है, फूल ही फूल है, एंड व्हेन एनीबॉडी आस्क यू दैट हाउ मेनी फ्लावर्स वेयर देयर, अब अगर आप बताओगे कि मैं एक गार्डन गया था, आई वेंट टू अ गार्डन एंड देयर वेयर एन नंबर ऑफ फ्लावर्स, बहुत सारे फ्लावर्स थे, तो आप क्या करो, क्या बोलोगे, देयर वेयर 100 फ्लावर्स, because you are not counted them. आप count कर सकते थे, excuse me, आप count कर सकते थे, but you haven't counted them. आपने count नहीं किया, आपने बस देखा कि flowers हैं, आपने देखा flowers है और n number of flowers. Okay, so in this सिचुएशन व्हाट डू वी टेल, जिस चीज को हम काउंट कर सकते हैं बट द नंबर वी डोंट नो, जिस चीज को हम काउंट कर सकते हैं बट द एग्जैक्ट नंबर वी डोंट नो, इंस्टीड ऑफ नंबर वी राइट मैनी, वी राइट मैनी, एम ए एन वाई मैनी. Now you can answer it. If anybody asks you how many flowers were there in the garden, garden mein kitne flowers the, ab aap bata sakte ho there were many flowers in the garden, there were many flowers in the garden. Why Harish has taught you this, so that you should know the use of many. We use the word many for the things that we can count, jin cheezon ko hum count kar sakte hain, the naming words that we can count, we use many for them. Okay, if we are unable to count those things, agar us cheez ko aap count nahi karte aur aap dekh rahe hoge to bahut sare hain, so you can call them many. Theek hai, you can call them many. There were many flowers in the garden, so there were many flowers in the garden. Repeat after me, there were, repeat it, there were many flowers in the garden. Okay, aur aapne dekha ki wahan pe bahut sare trees bhi hain, so what you will write, there were many trees in the garden, there are many trees in the garden. Aapne garden mein ye bhi dekha ki bahut sare bacche the, now one child, two child, three child, four child, five, fifth child and 6, 7, 8. There are n number of boys and n number of girls there. आपने दूर से देखा and you told that. Now आपसे पूछा कि बच्चे कितने थे? बहुत सारे बच्चे थे. So in that sense we can say there were many children. All these things can be counted. ये वो सारी naming words हैं जिनको हम count कर सकते हैं. और अगर इसके लिए आपको बहुत सारा इन हिंदी लिखना हो, बहुत सारा इन हिंदी एंड मेनी इन इंग्लिश, ओके, द एग्जैक्ट वर्ड ऑफ मेनी इन हिंदी इज कई, ओके. बागीचे में कई बच्चे थे, देयर वेर मेनी चिल्ड्रन इन द गार्डन, ओके. बागीचे में कई पेड़ थे, देयर वेर मेनी ट्रीज इन द गार्डन. बागीचे में कई फूल थे, और यू कैन से इन सिंपल सिंपल सेंस मेनी फ्लावर्स, देयर वेर मेनी फ्लावर्स इन द गार्डन. सो व्हाट डिड आई टीच यू, दैट इफ द थिंग्स वी कैन काउंट आर कॉल्ड काउंटेबल नाउंस. If you can count them in number, you tell them name number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 100 or 500 or any number. But अगर आपको in short बोलना है बहुत सारे, so for countable nouns we use m a n y many, m a n y many. Okay. Now हर चीज का एक opposite होता है, isn't it? हर चीज का एक ऑपोजिट होता है. जैसे हैप्पी का सर, फैट थिन, लॉन्ग शॉर्ट. लाइक वाइज काउंटेबल नाउन का भी अपोजिट होता है. जैसे हर नेमिंग वर्ड का अपोजिट होता है, वैसे ही काउंटेबल नाउन्स का भी अपोजिट होता है. एंड वी कॉल देम, what do we call them? We call them uncountable nouns. We call them uncountable nouns. Countable nouns, आपको समझ में आया? Have you understood on countable nouns? The things that can be counted are called countables. The things that can be counted are called countables. And the opposite of countables are uncountable. Okay, the opposite of countables are uncountable. Now I will teach you what are uncountable nouns. What are uncountable nouns? What I am going to teach you? Uncountable nouns. Now the next topic is uncountable nouns. U N C O U N T A B L E, uncountable nouns. Okay. Now, so two things I told you, that for uncountable, for countable nouns, if the things are greater in number and you have to use one word, that is many. Okay, so now come to page number 18. I'm reading up, reading it out, and you have to listen it carefully. The story, I am here at C1 on page number 18. The story of the two sculptors teaches us not to be mean. Did you notice how the sculptors can be counted? Sculptors को हमने count किया story में 1, 2. Whereas meanness cannot be, there are some nouns that can be counted In other words, they are countable. Like two sculptors, a king, three statues, etc. On the other hand, there are some nouns that cannot be counted. They are called uncountable. Like water, bread, kindness, or stars in the sky, etc. Let us learn more about them. Now, the naming words that you cannot count. They are naming words. वो नाम है बट आप उसे काउंट नहीं कर सकते. ओके, लाइक स्टार्स इन द स्काई, दे आर अनकाउंटेबल. ओके, दे आर, इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट वी कैन नॉट काउंट देम, बट दे आर एंडलेस. एंडलेस मतलब उनका कोई भी एंड पॉइंट एंड नंबर है ही नहीं. ओके, सो दे आर कॉल्ड uncountable. Like we cannot count water. We cannot count water. We can only measure water. आप water को count कर सकते हो क्या कि उसमें कितनी बूंदे हैं? Can you count the drop of water? You cannot count. Only you can count is this is 1 liter of water. Or you can count in measurement that this is a glass of water, but you cannot exactly count water. Okay, so water is an uncountable noun. Water is an uncountable noun. Okay, so here at page number 18 and one special one. The most important thing that agar. Suppose there are Okay, the number or the quantity, we use the word MUCH, much. MUCH, much. Now look here, there are two columns given. First is for countable nouns and second is for uncountable nouns. Now we will learn the difference between them in a tabular form. For countable noun, it is written countable nouns have singular and plural forms. Bahut important hai. Countable noun ka singular and plural hota hai. Jaise jab maine five flowers likha tha, I had used an S in flower. When I counted the ball, maine usme kya likha? It were, how many balls were there? Nine balls were there. I don't remember. So I have written nine balls. BALLS. That means if it was one, हमने लिखा होता one ball. और अगर वो more than one है तो उसमें हम एक s या es add करते हैं to show the plural form. So here this is saying that countable nouns have singular and plural form. Countable noun singular or plural form में होता है. For example, one king, two sculptors, five friends, six apples. But here it is saying that uncountable nouns do not have plural forms. Uncountable noun का plural form नहीं होता. ठीक है? Next is we can use a or an or a number before them to show how many they are. हम a an use कर सकते हैं और उनका number use कर सकते हैं उनको दिखाने के लिए show करने के लिए वो कितने हैं. Okay, for example an orange, a mango. But here for uncountable nouns it is given we do not use a an or numbers before them. For example water. Jealousy. Jealousy का मतलब क्या होता है? Water मतलब तो पानी होता है. What is the meaning of jealousy? Jealousy means jalan. ठीक है? One more example I can give you. Happiness. जब कोई अंदर से खुश होता है, तो हम उसकी खुशी को measure कर सकते हैं क्या? कि वो one, वो कितना happy है? One happy, two happy, three happy, four happy. No, we cannot count happiness in words. हम words में happiness को count नहीं कर सकते. That's why it is uncountable noun. अगर कोई बहुत sad है, तो क्या हम sadness को count कर सकते हैं? No, we cannot count the sadness in words. That's why sadness is also an uncountable noun. Here there are many countable and uncountable nouns are there. Okay, the examples are given. See, one more thing, many and much ka use bhi diya hua hai. We use many with countable nouns, for example many tools, and we use much with uncountable nouns, for example much love. And look at the following list of uncountable nouns carefully. Yahan there are many uncountables, uncountable nouns are given. Okay, I'm reading it out. Water, sugar, tea, oil, fun. These are uncountable nouns. The next row. Milk, salt, honey, paper, bravery. ये भी uncountable nouns हैं. Rice, flour, jam, help, love. We cannot count love and help. So these are uncountable nouns. Next is pasta, cheese, time. Time को भी count नहीं कर सकते. हम hour, minute, second को count कर सकते, but we cannot count time, the word time. Chess, bread, butter, air, mud, heat. गर्मी को भी count कर सकते हैं क्या? अगर कोई चीज गर्म है, okay? We can count, we can measure them. Yes, we can measure them in another sense. But we cannot count heat, dust, grass, land. So these are the things that are considered to be, they are uncountable nouns. Okay, now there is an exercise on page number 90, and there are, this is the book of, open your book, page number 90. And what you have to do, you have to underline the uncountable nouns and pen circle the, sorry, underline the countable nouns. जिसको count कर सकते हैं उसे underline करेंगे. And encircle the uncountable nouns. जिसे count नहीं कर सकते उसे circle करना है. What we need to do? Circle. Yes. So, shall I write the five sentences? I'm writing the five sentences. Number one, how many sentences are there? Once upon a time, there lived a kind king. Number one is, once upon, excuse me please. Countable nouns as well as uncountable nouns. This is on page number 19. On page number 19, we have to underline the countable. ठीक है? We can count kings. हम king को count कर सकते हैं? Yes, we can count king. So, as the question is saying as that, underline the countable and encircle the uncountable, जिसको हम count नहीं कर सकते. That means we cannot count time. So we encircled time and we cannot count kindness. हम kindness को भी count नहीं कर सकते. So the answer is time and kind are uncountable and king is countable. Now number two, I'm writing. Number two is in his kingdom. Kingdom का मतलब होता है उसके राज्य में. In his kingdom, there lived. Two sculptors. Now here kingdom we cannot count. Okay, kingdoms we can count. ठीक है, राज्य count कर सकते हैं ना. Like suppose we can count the kingdoms like इस राजा का kingdom, उस राजा का kingdom. Likewise, we can count kingdom, we can count sculptors, and as you see, this two is a number in itself. So, two sculptors, this shows countable nouns, and kingdom can be counted. So there are two countable nouns in this sentence, kingdom and two sculptors. Class 2, I know this is a little tough for you, but anyway you have to grow up. Iske baad class 3 mein bhi jayenge na, tab cheezein aur tough ho jayengi. That's why do regular practice of everything that you learn. जो भी नया चीज आप लर्न करेंगे उसे बार बार पढ़ना है, सो दैट इट विल नॉट रिमेन डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू। बार बार प्रैक्टिस करने से कोई भी चीज डिफिकल्ट नहीं हो जाती, वो आसान हो जाती है। ओके, जैसे बार बार टूल्स को रबिंग करने से वो क्या हो जाते हैं, शार्प हो जाते हैं, है ना। टूल्स को अगर शार्प करना है तो उसे बार बार उसके सरफेस को रब करना पड़ता है तो वो शार्प हो जाते हैं। लाइकवाइज अगर आपको माइंड को शार्प करना है तो रेगुलर प्रैक्टिस करनी पड़ेगी। नाउ नंबर थ्री, यू हैव टू मेक अ बस्ट ऑफ द केक। नंबर थ्री इज यू हैव टू मेक अ बस्ट ऑफ द केक, BUST, बस्ट ऑफ द केक। आपको किंग का बस्ट बनाना है। एक एक वर्ड देखो, इसमें बस एक नाउन है और किंग एक नाउन है। जस्ट थिंक ओवर कि बस एंड किंग को आप काउंट कर सकते हो या नहीं। देन आफ्टर दैट वी विल अंडरलाइन और वी विल एनसर्कल अनाउंस द विराट, AMOUNCED, अनाउंस्ड। अनाउंस्ड, अनाउंस करने का मतलब होता है किसी भी चीज को सबको बताना, दैट इज कॉल्ड अनाउंस। दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अनाउंस। दैट लाइक व्हेन यू कम टू द स्कूल, जब आप असेंबली में होते हो तो मैसेजेस अनाउंस होते हैं दैट डियर स्टूडेंट्स काइंडली पे अटेंशन दैट टुमारो यू हैव टू कम इन सैटरडे यूनिफॉर्म, और डियर स्टूडेंट्स काइंडली पे अटेंशन। माइक में ऐसा अनाउंसमेंट होता है ना, सो द सेम अनाउंसमेंट इज दिस, यू हैव टू मेक अ बस्ट ऑफ द किंग, अनाउंस्ड द हेराल्ड। नाउ हु इज अ हेराल्ड? हेराल्ड इज अ पर्सन, दैट मीन्स वी कैन काउंट हेराल्ड ऑल्सो। सो देर आर थ्री काउंटेबल नाउंस, बस्ट, हेरल्ड एंड द किंग। सो इन दिस सेंटेंस वी गॉट थ्री काउंटेबल नाउंस। बस्ट, स्टैचू को हम काउंट कर सकते हैं, किंग, राजा को भी काउंट किया जा सकता है, एंड हेरल्ड, मैसेंजर को भी काउंट कर सकते हैं। सो दे आर काउंटेबल नाउंस। नाउ टू मोर सेंटेंसेस आर देयर, read out number 4 and 5 till I am erasing it. Number 4 is Lakshman won the competition easily. Lakshman won the competition easily.
Lakshman is a person.
Lakshman is a countable noun and competition we yes competitions are can also be counted like जैसे आपको अगर पूछेंगे कि how many competitions were there in the month of April, April में कितने competitions थे, तो you can easily tell कि handwriting competition था और like best out of waste competition था and one sort of GK competition were there, so there were three competitions. So competition can also be counted. So this is also a countable noun. Noun number five. Number five is Chandra lost. Now who is Chandra? Chandra is a person. So Chandra is also a countable noun. So we can underline Chandra because Chandra is a countable noun. Chandra lost because BECAUSE. In any of the class I have told you, I think I might have told you, because means kyunki, because of his folly and jealousy. So as we cannot count happiness and sadness, जैसे हम happiness और sadness को count नहीं कर सकते, वैसे ही हम folly and jealousy को भी count नहीं कर सकते, so they are uncountable noun. And Chandra is countable. Okay, and there is a short exercise after this on page number 20. And here we have to write much or many. मैंने आपको बताया है जिसको count कर सकते हैं उसमें many लिखेंगे, जिसको count नहीं कर सकते उसमें much लिखेंगे. Okay? So I am erasing it. So this is the TC2 exercise in your book, and it says what it says. It says write much many before the following nouns. And here there are 1, 2, 3, 4. Five blanks are there. The first says dash kings. If we can count it, many aayega, agar nahi kar sakte to much aayega. Sculptors.